President Trump talks about fake news on a regular basis, and of course, some of our friends in the rest of the media don't like that, and they take such umbrage that you have to believe Trump must be hitting pretty close to the bone when he makes these criticisms. Ann Coulter has written about this recently. She is the syndicated columnist and best-selling author of Resistance is Futile, How the Trump-Hating Left Has Lost Its Collective Mind, especially those at, say, MSNBC and the Chicken Noodle News Network. Right, Ann?
I like that chicken noodle news. It certainly is not news. Do not be fooled by the constant statements. CNN, the most trusted name in news. No, they had a, for those of you who haven't read my column, they had a full segment Sunday night, good 10 minutes, analyzing a fake quote where they slipped the word white into something that, President Trump, and according to them, also Don Jr. said in the middle of the Kavanaugh nonsense with the false accusations to prevent a fabulous Supreme Court nominee from being appointed. Trump had given a statement saying it's a scary time to be a young man in America where you can be accused of something you're not guilty of. This, according to CNN's Anna Cabrera and everyone else invited to comment on it, was Trump and his son saying it's a scary time to be a white man in America. White. They just slip in the word white, something Trump did not say. And as I've mentioned, you know, there are hundreds of thousands of words in the English language. If this was just a mistake, why not, you know, coffee machine? Why not computer monitor or trophy? No, white was slipped in. And it was a premeditated lie. It was mixed in. I describe each handoff in the creation of fake news, with some guy on Saturday Night Live saying something about Trump saying, ooh, this old white dude saying it's a scary time. Oh, that's comedy gold or something like that. This is what comedians say when they have nothing funny to say. It's like flashing a sign at the audience. Laugh now. Please laugh now. Oh, that's comedy gold. That's so comedic. No, that's not a punchline. That's you running out of anything interesting to say. In any event, there was an entire segment on this. It was an absolute lie. No correction. This isn't news. This is a network that is trying to create the sort of racial hatred that gets people killed.
I got to tell you, Ann, my rule for mentioning race has always been if it's relevant to the story. And yet I see race being pumped into various situations where it has no relevance to the story. But as you say, it amps up the excitement that the media gets when they say, well, a white police officer shot a black man. Well, really, is there any indication that the officer shot the black man because he was black? Or maybe because of the knife or the gun in his hand. And yet people
say... Well, particularly
say,
when they have such an elastic definition of white.
Yeah, well, there's that, too.
There was George Zimmerman, who was about 80% Hispanic. No, if it's a cop, they just assume white. But here, that's when they're talking. Yes, they are constantly injecting race into things. Here, they were accusing Donald Trump of only worrying about white men. White men. And then bring in, you know, Professor Mark Lamont Hill to comment on this. And, oh, well, it's another example of white supremacy in our country. I mean, it went on and on and on this whole segment. Like I say, it was premeditated. None of the rest of the segment made sense if the quote had been accurate, that Trump had said it's a scary time for young men. Only if you lie and insert white men in there do you bring on, you know, a professor of urban studies and host of the BET network to talk about white supremacy. Halfway through the segment, Anna Cabrera switched her lie from something we made up in the back room here at CNN to an actual Trump strategy, asking, will this Trump strategy work? It's really absolutely outrageous, and in my note to readers, and I wish anyone listening would go find it and print it out, put it in your wallet for the next time people say, oh, there's no such thing as fake news, these are the guardians of the First Amendment, yes, every once in a while there's a typo. No, this was a deliberate, vicious, racist lie about the president. Not only was it not corrected in that segment, if this had been a mistake, I think it would have been corrected before before the first commercial break and, you know, come up with something different to talk about. As far as I know, it has never been corrected on CNN. Anna Cabrera, after, or I guess, I don't know, about the same time my column was running, other people may have noticed this, she sent out this vague tweet saying, I made an error. Sorry about that. Something to that effect. Absolutely no mention of what the error was. It goes to her pathetic list of Twitter followers. And as small as CNN's ratings are, I believe more people saw her segment with the lie than, you know, went to Anna Cabrera's Twitter feed to see this vague, I made an error. How about a segment correcting the entire segment?
Well, and what's crazy is they could have done some legitimate journalism and said, it is a scary time to be a man now. And I'll tell you, this is one of the things I kept emphasizing, is if somebody can come out with a thinly evidenced accusation that has nothing behind it, no witnesses, no nothing, and the person bringing the, you know, charge can't even remember all the details, where, when, yes, who, how, and that can destroy a man or, and as I've pointed out in these gender fluid times, a man or a woman's, their entire career, their good name, their family, wipe them out financially and say, oh, I'm sorry, it was a false accusation, or we think it was false. But by this time, you've already destroyed the person. It is a scary time when that one little accusation can end up destroying a person. And wait until the first time, you know, that a woman says, well, you know, this professional woman came on to me, and they destroy a doctor or a lawyer or a politician or somebody else.
Well, I think the one time you can be sure you're going to see it again is when Trump gets another Supreme Court nominee, which is why I am insistent that he make it a man. Everyone thinks, oh, don't worry, they won't be able to do anything with a woman. Yeah, because, you know, they loved Sarah Palin. They totally love me. No, they'll just come up with something new. Now that we know what their playbook is, they're not going to be able to pull the false allegation of a high school groping on the next one. It would be too embarrassing.
So they'll have to do something slightly different. And frankly, you know what you reminded me of? Do you remember back when the ridicule was heaped on Gerald Ford? Because Chevy Chase portrayed him as being incredibly clumsy. And we knew, if you looked at the man's history, he was an athlete. He was,
he was a football player at University of Michigan.
And a standout. He was a standout football player who did very, very well. But if you have a comedian pretend that the president is a clumsy guy, then people today will say, well, you know, you remember how clumsy Gerald Ford was? And you say, no, he wasn't. That was the comedian playing the parody on the anti-Republican, pro-left television show Saturday Night Live. It had no, but it becomes, and they used to make fun of Reagan, saying, oh, Reagan imagined those things from the movies. And then you'd go back and say, no, that was actually based on history. It's you folks who are pretending that things happened in the movies.
Well, this is what's driving them absolutely mad about the internet. They seem to still believe they're operating in a world without the internet, thus the deplatforming. Well, they've started with Alec Jones and Roger Stone and Gavin McGinnis. Ooh, they're coming after Gavin McGinnis, one of the funniest people in America. Who else? Oh, Milo Yiannopoulos. Yeah, they'll start with those, but they're coming for us, Lars.
Well, let's start doing it back at them. John Zemirak, who's a friend of mine, I stole the line from him, but I told him, if you're not going to tweet it, I will. Because he said it to me tonight.
I agree. No. I think this I was accused of the pretend and former journalist Soledad O'Brien yesterday of being a Nazi apologist and white supremacist. And for all of your listeners who are on Twitter, would you please find that tweet and report her to Twitter? Being a Nazi apologist is a crime that can get you imprisoned in many countries in Europe.
That's very true. Her book is called Resistance is Futile. She is Ann Coulter and a great friend of the Lars Larson Show.